Mr. Gus is gonna help me.
He's having a little snack, aren't you?
Yes. So our news for this week is that we settled on our house. So we are officially mortgage free. I just cannot wait to see the savings.
You're right. Do you want some more?
We're officially mortgage free, so I cannot wait to see our savings just start climbing and climbing and climbing. It's just very exciting to know that now the mortgage is done. We have a solid 6 or 7 months of just being able to save like crazy. So we sat down and looked at our budget and realistically how much we can put aside every week. And yeah, it's just exciting to think that we'll be able to put so much money away now that we don't have our mortgage. Super lucky and fortunate that we can live with our in-laws or my in-laws. It means the world to us that we can save this much, and it's such a great opportunity for us. So yes, saving like crazy. Really weird feeling that the house isn't ours anymore. We didn't even get a photo in front of the house when it sold. We've just been so busy. We did a little sneaky drive-by because it's just a couple blocks away. And they're like, you know, putting up stuff in the house, and it's just surreal. Like, we never really had that goodbye moment to the house because we'd moved out, the stylists came in, cleaners came through. Like, everything just happened in the end, and we didn't really have to go there very much. So, it's weird to think that it's not ours anymore because we never really got that final closure to say goodbye to our house, I guess. And if you've been watching, you know that house has a lot of memories for us. I don't know. We never had that final goodbye. I didn't get emotional like I thought I would leaving the house or once it finally, you know, handing over the keys and everything. It was just kind of like, yep, let's go, let's do this. Don't know if it was because it was just a really hard slog at the end, getting everything over the line. But yeah, it's done. So bye-bye house. Hello, house on wheels.
What? Yummy. Is that cheese yummy?
Yummy cheese.
Yum, 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 yum. Oh.
You just want to see yourself. So, as you might have seen on Instagram, we've been chatting to our caravan company that we bought off because there's been some delays with the recurring lockdowns and just getting stuff into Australia, being able to put together the chassis and also things for inside the van like microwaves, fridges, air conditioning units, stuff like that. So initially when we went and spoke to them, they said it should be ready by November, December, but let's say Feb to put a bit of fat on that estimate to make sure that it arrived on time and that if there were delays that we were realistic that it would be around February that we'd get our caravan. So that was fine. And then we got an email saying they were behind by about 8 weeks. So we didn't know if that meant 8 weeks from December, like November, December, or 8 weeks from our February date. So I contacted them just to clarify what was going on, and they told us, well, actually it's more like 14 weeks and 14 weeks from February. So we were looking at now June, maybe even July. So that meant a whole year of waiting for the van, which we were just really uncomfortable with. I emailed them and said, hey, this is the situation. We've sold our house. This caravan isn't a weekender for us. We're actually about to tour Australia. And we've sold everything. We're living with our in-laws. Like, it's not an ideal situation. Like, it wasn't meant to be permanent or more than, you know, a couple of months. Is there anything you can do? Are there any lot vans that have become available? Have there been cancellations? Just trying to figure something out so that we could get the van and get on the road as quick as possible. And they were amazing. She called me and said, listen, these are your three options, and kind of went through each one and what that meant and what it would look like. So in the end, she ended up being able to swap one of their orders that they had for a lot van for themselves, like a demo van, to our build. So theirs was meant to get started around November, and that had been pushed back to February, March. So we then claimed that spot, and they've taken our build spot for the following June, July. So we were amazed that they were able to do that for us, and so thankful. So that's amazing. We'll hopefully still get our van if everything plays out around that February, maybe March timeline. So yes, very exciting. They said they're trying to catch up on these back orders, but it's just been a massive thing for all the manufacturers. So yeah, totally understand. We knew there would be some delays. We just didn't think it would be by 3 or 4 months. So yeah, that's kind of what's happened this week in our major news for our caravan. We woke up to that news one morning, the email, and we were just devo. We were so devastated. I messaged Oscar and said, hey, I flicked you an email, have a read. And he called me straight away and was like, oh my goodness, what are we going to do? You know, we can't be living with my parents for a whole year. It's not fair. Not fair on them because we didn't plan for that. There's not a whole heap of room here for all of us. So it was never our intention to be here long term. It was more a few months to save before our van arrived. So yeah, amazed at the situation and the outcome. Let's just hope it stays that way. Maybe they'll be able to catch up some time, fingers crossed. But with all these COVID lockdowns and manufacturing delays around Australia, I highly doubt it. So we'll see how we go. We're remaining hopeful and we'll see what happens. So we'll keep you posted in the coming weeks if we hear any more news. Planning to go up and do our colour selections and final selections on what we want, and making sure the van's the way we want it before it starts getting manufactured, hopefully early August. So we'd love to film that and show you the process of doing all your finalizations for your order. Just looking back at some of our old videos and I'm tanned. Winter here, middle of winter, July. So it's gloomy and rainy and cold. I'm not keen for winter this year at all. What am I here to tell you? We started trip planning in more detail this week. So the map went up and we just had a bit of a brief look at, you know, direction that we'll go. A lot of it depends on when we get our caravan. If we're going to be delayed, we'll probably head straight over to WA to catch the good weather, and then we'll go up through the NT after that, because that puts our trip around May, June. So that's when we'll get the top end good weather, and when it's meant to be less windy in WA apparently. So that's the plan. This week we've just started actually highlighting on the map all the places we want to go. So that's based off a couple of travel blogs that we follow and some people that have recommended things. We bought Trip In A Van's itinerary planner, so that's been really handy. Considering looking at big lap Bibles as well, so we need to find out some more information about that. But yeah, super excited to actually start nutting it out, and the planner in me wants to open an Excel spreadsheet and like go through where we want to stay and what we want to do in each place. We don't want to have a plan of how long we're in each place for, because we don't know what we're going to like but I just want to know when we're going into an area, roughly what we're going to see, where we're going to go, where to head. Don't want it to be too planned. We want it to kind of just happen, but we don't want to miss stuff. I think that's the big thing. We don't want to miss out and be like, oh, that was back there. We've got to, oh, come back. But yeah, I'm sure we'll plan along the way, but I just kind of want in my head to know that we've got all the big things that we want to do roughly planned out, where they are and what time of year is the best time to do them. So yeah. Quick little-